Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live here on this 16th day of April 2014 on this Wednesday Worldwide Edition. We are going to open the phones up today on a whole bunch of subjects, and then William F. Jasper will be joining us for about 45 minutes in the second hour to talk about the waterfront, global governance, the move towards UN and corporate rule, the different global partnerships that are merging the different planetary agreements together into one world government. The editor of the New American Magazine is going to be joining us coming up. And as I said, we'll have open phones later in this hour and in the third hour today. There's a very interesting article up on DrudgeReport.com. Shock, 86 million workers sustain 148 million benefit takers. That's right. Does that sound like a free or fair society where 86 million people work to sustain 148 million benefit takers, government benefit takers? That's not women and children that are being sustained by the man working. No, no, no. They got rid of men being the head of the household a long time ago. The state is now the head. And then it takes the money and hands it out to anyone who'll vote to take guns, anyone that'll vote for open borders, anyone that'll vote to break down the society. This is the nanny state. It's backed up by a giant paramilitary armor vehicle, machine gun wielding force that trains 24/7 to take on the American people. There's another story right underneath it up on DrudgeReport.com. Report, FBI visiting gun shops to investigate people talking about big government. If you see some Middle Eastern guy come in, you don't have to be so worried about that, close quote. And we have the latest FBI flyer. And that's what they've said officially last year. They're not worried about Middle Eastern radical Islam threats. In fact, the government's openly funding Al-Qaeda now. No, no, no. It's all domestic, libertarian, veteran gun owners. And you see, it's a self-fulfilling prophecy where the system gears up, arms up, and then comes after the American people, knowing a confrontation will start somewhere. Who knows which side will be in the wrong. And then the war starts, the civil war. Everything I do is to try to stop that civil war. Every day, I harp on it perpetually. But you've got Media Matters, you've got CNN, MSNBC, and Glenn Beck constantly saying that I want violence and that I am trying to call for a violent revolution when I'm calling for a intellectual revolution, a cultural revolution to counter their cultural revolution. But if you're being attacked wrongly, you have a right and a duty to protect yourself. And I'm on record always saying that. When the government creates free speech zones in the middle of the desert and beats people up and points guns at people, then you see a bunch of other citizens show up with guns saying, don't do that. The feds say we're going to shoot you. The people march forward with the guns at their sides. Only probably 20-30% were armed from the videos I've seen. Our reporters were there. Walking peacefully towards the feds, past them, trumping their bluff. It's a giant victory. And it really shows why we have a Second Amendment for peace. In fact, what's the motto of the U.S. Army? Strength through superior firepower. Peace through superior firepower. Peace through superior firepower. And that's why the people have the guns as the trump for what we see now happening. Let's get that straight. We're going to come back and look at the frame-up of the Tea Party straight ahead, honchoed by you-know-who. Obviously, the situation with Russia and Ukraine is deteriorating. The stock market is deteriorating. The derivatives overhang of 1.5 quadrillion, that's hard to even say that number, 1,500 trillion, is completely untenable. We're going to be going over all of that today. William F. Jasper of the New American Magazine is going to be joining us to talk about the UN takeover, Bill Clinton's executive order to hand over much of the U.S. as collateral to the UN, and how that ties into UNESCO and the situation with the Bundy Ranch, and a lot more. That's all coming up. And at the bottom of the hour, I'm going to get into this stunning report at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. It's also in the middle column of DrudgeReport.com. FBI visiting gun shops to investigate people talking about big government. And then we have one of the flyers that was handed out. I know this report to be accurate because Brandon Tuberville is an excellent investigative journalist. We carry his work almost every day at Infowars. And it's all turned out to be accurate in the past. But I already know all this. I mean, I've already seen the training manuals. We published them. It's been in the news that they're trying to take on the Tea Party, and that's now West Point's main training mission. And it's been in AP and Reuters and everywhere else that, you know, now we're not worried about Al-Qaeda or Muslim radicals. We're worried about domestic groups, returning veterans, gun owners who want to have a war. And again, this is a self-fulfilling prophecy where the system's trying to start this civil war that you hear me harp on constantly. That's coming up at the bottom of the hour because it dovetails with everything I'm about to cover right now. Everyone knows that I have dedicated myself really in the last 19 years, but particularly the last two, to not infight. If I agree with 90% of what somebody stands for and does, even if they attack me, I will not fight back. I will expose the big central banks that fund socialism at the grassroots, exempt themselves from the socialism. That's fascism on top of it. It's really a form of crony, monopolistic capitalism, and it's the scourge of civilization, the scourge of productivity, the scourge of freedom, of innovation. Everyone knows that I have done my best to try to promote anyone and everyone that's doing good work. We're a broadcast like no other where you see other radio talk show hosts, other filmmakers, other talk show hosts that even have shows directly up against me. I don't even care because I want to try to take our understanding of the globalist paradigm and share that with everyone so that there's a mass awakening. I want to beat the New World Order. That's my goal. Glenn Beck said, and we've played the clips, that Ron Paul, with his money bomb, was planning to blow things up. He said that 7 years ago. And we have that on tape. And then he said it again a few years later. And I played the clip. I'm not going to go over it again. But it was when he was on CNN. He knew the public didn't know what money bomb meant. And he said they're trying to get money to blow things up, a bomb. Like Guy Fawkes, it's very dangerous. We need the army to go after these Ron Paul supporters. Of course, you know what a money bomb is today. Everybody does because it became so popular and lots of groups call it that. He's a master of lying to his audience. And that's why he's getting sued. And I want to believe he's a good guy because he does a lot of good work. But he knows the FEMA camps are real, the Emergency Centers Establishment Act, and the Civilian Inmate Labor Camp Program, and they don't call it a FEMA camp. Of course, he went searching for FEMA camps and didn't find them and went and found a fake internet one that I even predicted he would go show. I mean, I just know how these people work. And still, I got upset about that. I got upset about all the rest of it, and I've just left it alone. But when somebody with 15 million listeners over the week and with all the rest of it sits there, and day in, day out, week in, week out, frames what we stand for on this show, lies about us, it's very, very frustrating. And frames what's going on with the Bundys and lies and says there's no Harry Reid connection to this and there's no Chinese connection. I mean, we have the BLM documents from last year where they said we've got to get Bundy off the property. for the easement for the solar panels. You have to take it off use under UN rules to then make the other, quote, biosphere area on use. It's an environmental easement where we'll let you build on this, but you've got to buy acreage over here and put it in trust. It's in the document. It's in the story breaking. Senator Harry Reid behind BLM land grab of Bundy Ranch. And they've now had Breitbart come out. And I'm going to debunk this with Brandon Darby. How many people know that Brandon Darby's an admitted FBI asset who works for the Federal Bureau of Investigation? You just look his name up. This is an FBI operative. They have the FBI writing articles saying, we're full of prunes, to quote Dan Rather. No, we're not. So I love how we got Breitbart and Glenn Beck running around saying we're full of it on that. And if, there it is, Wikipedia, Brandon Darby's an American informant for the Federal Bureau of Investigation. And that'd be fine if you're somebody like, you know, the folks we've had on that exposed the Weatherman and people like that. My only issue is you should disclose that in the headline. FBI asset says Alex Jones is full of baloney.